Denny Moyer's on the line this morning. Denny, good morning.
Good morning, Dave. Great game, isn't it?
Oh, wow. I'll tell you, it's a nice way to bump the record up to 8-3 with four quick ones, and to do that on the road is pretty impressive.
Yeah, they played very well. They got the job done out there. We got good pitching, and we got some timely hits. We got some execution, and it turned out just great for us.
It's hard to beat any team. A typical series is three games. Hard to win three straight over anybody. When you do it four straight, you're doing a lot of things right.
Well, at their place especially, and especially on this level, you know, not everybody can make every trip. There's always family commitments and job commitments and stuff, so you don't always have your guys in the road. But we had a good chairman, and they did the job. So it was really, really fun. The first game went into extra innings, and we got a big hit in the bottom of the seventh, which we play seven-inning doubleheaders. And Harry Stelt drove in a winning run, Jake Perez drove in the winning run. We got three hits before that. Then in the eighth inning, it's tied 1-1. We get an out. We get a hit batsman. We get a pinch hitter. Ben Gordon gets in there and dumps a bunt, moves the runner up. And we get a big base hit to win the game by Colin Willis. So 2-1 in extra innings. So that was first one. Then the second one, we got four runs in the first inning and held on. Brandon Winfield threw, eight strikeouts or nine. And on Sunday, it was 2-1 again. Big hit for Chad Langley, who last year won three or four games, driving in runs with clutch hits. And the last one, we erupted and beat them 10-2. So it was quite a weekend.
We talked a little bit about Friday, about this being a tough stretch of games, a lot of road games, four in Eau Claire. Now you go to Chicago Chicago or Lombard this weekend. A lot of tough games, early season tests, but some nice early momentum.
Yeah, this one really helps because I was a little upset over Thursday night's game at Kenosha. We didn't play especially well, and we had a tough trip going down there and a stupid highway construction and all that stuff. We just got there on time, and so we got off on a bad start, but then the kids bounced back over the weekend, so that was great.
All right, let's talk about the early part of this week. One more road game here tomorrow night at Manitowoc, and then you're home for one of the big nights of the season, sponsors and friends. That's Wednesday night home game this week.
Yeah, we go to Manitowoc Tuesdays, right, another northeastern Wisconsin game, and then Wednesday's our sponsors night. We do that every year, Dave. We invite all of the people who buy season tickets or buy ads in our book or outfield fence walls or in one way or another help us sponsor nights or something. And we have a little cocktail party before the game, and then we introduce the players to them, and we talk about our program a little bit. And it's kind of a fun night. I hope the weather holds up. I'm talking about a little rain for Wednesday, so hopefully that won't interfere. So we're looking forward to that. Then over the weekend, we go to Lombard again, and that'll be the challenge. He's always got a great ball club down. I think he's won it 12 or 13 years in a row. So playing at their place is tough. But first thing we got to do is beat Manitowoc Tuesday night, so then we'll see what we can do.
All right, Denny, we'll go get them tomorrow night. I know it's a tough week with a lot of road games early in the season, but soon the schedule will flip, and a lot of those games will be at home instead.
Yeah, we got a pretty good home schedule in July, so hopefully that's when we're going to make some racket. Good morning, Dave.
Well, these are good times for the A's. Big sweep over the weekend up in Eau Claire, and then on the road again last night, another road win for the A's at Manitowoc.
Yeah, we went up to 9-3 now. We got a nice start to the season going, and had a nice game last night. First inning, Eric Solberg knocks one out of the yard, and that kind of set the pace for things, and we played well defensively, and Taylor Schwartz gave us a great game on the mound again. He's really consistently solid for us, and got a bunch of hits, and we just racked up a win over Manitowoc.
We talk pretty often about after a loss, you know, that's next up, next game, new night. But we don't get to talk too often about momentum, and you've got some early season momentum, and you can kind of ride that for a while.
Yeah, let's hope so, because things are really looking good. I really kind of like this ball club. I said that at the start, that I thought we had a chance to have a nice team. And what is really looking good is our depth. We've got, I don't know, five or six really solid outfielders that can all hit and run and play out there. And we've got some strong middle infielders that can play. We got some guys that hit with power. We got good defensive catcher. So, and our pitching has been solid, so it looks like we got a chance to really contend this year. And we'll find out this weekend. We go to Lombard this weekend, you know, and I think they've won the thing 12 or 13 years in a row, so we'll find out whether we can play this weekend. But first, we got Sponsors Night. That's coming up tonight, and hopefully, like you said a little earlier, that we'll get the weather out of here, and we'll be in good shape for that.
Yeah, hopefully the rain moves out as forecasted, and tonight Oshkosh comes in for the Sponsors and Friends Night, and ball game starts at 7:30, but lots going on at the park before the game gets started.
Yeah, at 5:30 we start. We have a little cocktail party for them for all of the people who bought tickets or bought ads or gave us contributions, and in some cases physically helped us, you know, worked at the field or did things or whatever. We call it Sponsors and Friends Night, and we introduce the players to all of them, and then the players are going to mingle with the people, and it's a fun night. We have a good time every year with it, and it's just become a tradition. Hopefully we don't have to set up the tents tonight. I'm a little nervous. You're trying to assure me here, but I'm getting a little bit nervous over the weather. Hopefully it'll be okay.
Well, and, you know, there are big games throughout the season and important games in the league race and things like that, but it's always nice to play a good ball game in front of this group that'll be out there tonight, because these are your key supporters and sponsors, and it doesn't always go according to Hoyle, but it's nice to play it play a good ball game when these folks are out there tonight.
Yeah, it is. We've got this kind of a tradition going. Whenever I get a big crowd, for one thing, we either play like an hour and a half game or 2 hour game or something, send them all home, or else we play a 10 run rule game and we send them all home. And then when I get 50 or 60 people out there, then we play for 3.5 hours, you know, and it's kind of a crazy thing, but we're looking to have a couple, 300-400 people there tonight, and hopefully we'll give them a good ball game, and hopefully the weather will hold up and everything will work.